I killed my coffee while I was waiting, or like on the other call, so I have to go grab more.
I'm almost done with my coffee, but I think I'm gonna drink cranberry juice after my coffee.
I'm drinking green tea with some honey and apple cider vinegar.
Yes, we support. Welcome, welcome. Who's in? But not just Kai. Kai, you showed up twice, Kai.
I know. I'm joining on my phone.
You went.
Oh yes, the phone's the one doing the picture.
Yeah. I'm trying to turn on my camera now, though.
Do you see that?
Ooh, ooh. Did I hear some Star Wars music?
Did you hear it? Can you guys hear me and the music?
Don't see me. This is like back in the day before there was like legit ones. It's like that. That good old. Oh yeah, Kai, I would pin your drawing.
I think after we have a couple people, then Kai will be the one sharing the screen from her phone. So we can see that.
Yeah, just let me know when you want me to stop sharing the screen. Mm-hmm.
Is that clear? Can y'all see it? Is that what?
I was watching Rogue One yesterday. I need to finish it today, but I want to watch all the Star, like, start from Rogue One and then down the line with the Star Wars movies.
You were having like a mini marathon, low key.
I can. Huh? I got that Disney Plus. Yeah. I thought they were supposed to put the new one out on Disney Plus today.
They are. Is it not up?
I haven't checked yet.
Hey. Okay. I have all my colors. I'm ready to go.
You good?
What's that?
Colors too.
Respect.
Okay. What time is it? I'm gonna grab some more. I'll be right back.
Go for it.
Gotcha. Oh
no. Let's go ahead. Was that Elizabeth, or was that Kai?
I almost killed my dog right now.
Were you about to step on him?
What?
Were you gonna step on him?
Oh yeah, she went under my feet. She's tiny. She's a little weenie dog. Okay.
Do we all have our colors ready?
I have like three of each color.
Dang, I only have one of each.
That's fine. You know what? We're gonna, if we go over the coloring and we have enough time, we're gonna cover shading. But I think that's what makes this one look cute. This is probably my favorite one that I've done.
So cute. I even have
the other one.
Well, that was the, that's the one, that's the first one you showed me.
Yeah. So I changed it because I'm doing the, for the advocates, we're doing online stuff too, where it's already pre-recorded, so it's not Zooms, but we're doing that Baby Yoda for it.
That's cute.
So I was like, okay, I want to do Baby Yoda for both because it's May and I want my first one to end up being him. So different version.
Melissa, welcome. Yes, we have Jackie. Welcome, Jackie.
I feel like so many people are so excited right now. They're gonna be a lot, I bet you.
I know.
Petrifying.
I'm excited. Who's coming in? I'm excited to see their gear. If any of you have a t-shirt or any Star Wars gear, don't be afraid to show yourself on camera. That's what I'm excited. I can't believe we're like low-key 20.
I know. What? Three of us came ready.
We're like, yeah, the baby.
The baby.
The baby. We have the baby.
Where did you learn how to draw? Was it just like freehand or did you learn from?
I've drawn since I was younger. My mom's really good at drawing by eye.
Mm-hmm.
So I kind of watched her since I was young do it. But then in middle school, that's when it took over. I wasn't happy with any of like the signs that I would see everyone doing for like our dress up days and the themes or whatever. So I was like, I'll do it, forget it. So I got really good at drawing what I see. So if you were to show me a picture of something that you'd like or would want to draw, I could get pretty close. I mean, I can't copy it identically, but I a lot of my free time in general, that was all I did.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so it wasn't like, oh, natural. It's like, it progressed. It definitely progressed. But I have all my originals from when I was in middle school, and some of them I'm pretty impressed with because I was like, you had a lot of free time to do that. But I really liked it. My favorite ones are probably Aladdin and Jasmine. I drew them for one of our Disney theme days. I don't think I'll ever be able to copy that. It's like so spot on.
Try it again. You could do another tutorial.
Oh my gosh. See, that's the other thing. I'm obsessed with Disney, and I know a lot of other people might not be the same. So if I had it my way, it would just be all Disney.
I'm for it.
And so I'm like, I don't know. Trying to do something different. I think it's going to be the second video. I don't know how to explain it. They're basically letters that, but the front of like cards that you could send to your friends, since we're all virtual, you can actually go send a piece of like paper and say hi.
Yeah.
That you made yourself. And I'm excited about that one because it's not necessarily a cartoon.
Make sure you send us the videos when you share them so we can put them up on our YouTube.
Yes, yes, yes. Sounds good.
Yeah, that would be fun.
I'm trying to make old school things like that come back. Do some classic letters, do some calligraphy. I want to try doing calligraphy like to teach other people because that took me a while to learn, but I can do that now.
Welcome, welcome. Welcome, Kim. Good to see you.
I was laughing at our meeting this morning because I realized that my Ryan Gosling Hey Girl freaking fellow was behind me, and I was like trying to hide it. I was like,
was it really? I didn't notice.
I was freaking out.
You can display it loud and proud.
Please, as you're coming in, make sure you put your coyote IDs. Thank you.
Anyone else wearing some awesome Star Wars gears that they want to show off?
Really, you want to show off?
Three people right here.
Look at Jackie, it's really cool. The tie dye. Aw.
Hey, we love this.
They have
the child.
Let me go ahead and see who else. Consuelo has baby, the baby, I believe. She has him.
Oh, nice, nice.
It's so cute. Yeah. Aw.
Build the bear. Were they able to snag that? I unfortunately was not able to, and that's very sad.
They have a build a bear?
Yeah, he came out. I think for order a week ago, 2 weeks ago.
What?
Yeah, I was so sad when I realized it was too late, and so I went to try and go get him, and he was already sold out.
Aww. Oh, she got it from the Disney store online.
That, do you know how fast it sold out? Like within seconds. I keep missing. I'm not good at online shopping, guys.
You gotta be quicker than that.
Exactly. I'm not the one.
I know. I'm like so bad. I remember one time someone was trying to get tickets for like their mom for like a concert, and they were like struggling. Like they had 10 computers open trying to get it, and I'm like, I'm the one, I'm one of the few that's not gonna help you because I know I'm not gonna get it. I'm sorry. Oh, she gave you the lit. Oh, look at her.
My girl.
Oh, she said,
you hooking it up. We love that.
Have you seen the new face masks?
No.
No.
They have the child face masks. Like, it's his little cute cartoon face on the mask. I ordered that. I got that.
Is it like stitched on?
No, I think it's just printed on.
Done.
Oh, that's cool. The masks are gonna be a new thing just in regular day in life. And when I go to Disneyland, you bet I'm gonna have Disney masks on. Like,
right.
I ordered the Star Wars because it comes with 4 and it's $20, which is actually pretty good if you think about it. And I ordered the Mickey and Minnie one.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
They have those at the Disney store?
Yeah, it's online.
Oh, okay.
They're super cute. They have a classic, like, old school Star Wars poster as one. That was one that we, yeah, it's okay. Cute.
No, I'm going to look into that.
10 out of 10, recommend. I haven't even gotten it yet. It's like, yes.
I only have, like, a plain black one, and that's it.
My mom, let me see, my mom sewed a bunch of them, so we have, like, the Japanese print here. We got Hawaiian print.
Ooh.
My family was stressing, let me tell you.
I know, I have a Mickey one.
You, oh, I'm jealous.
I'll bring it out. I'll bring it out. Trust me.
Hi, guys.
Welcome, welcome.
Hello.
Are we all ready? Do we all have our papers, pencils, color pencils, and pen, whiteout.
Make sure we're gonna start sketching first, so that's gonna just be with pencil because nothing is permanent right now.
What do they say? They say like light brush strokes or something.
Yes, we're lightly sketching.
Lightly sketching.
Well, Ms. Kai will allow you to do a little introduction first of who you are, your role in ASI.
Hi guys, my name's Kai. I'm a student advocate here on campus. Oh, well, that's sad. Virtual campus, Zoom campus. I am a psychology second year major, and then I'm also minoring in studio art, hoping to have a concentration in animation. So yes, today we're gonna. I'm Baby Yoda. the child, and I'm very excited.
Yes.
If you guys could, if you haven't already, put your full name and your student IDs in the Zoom group chat. That way we're able to keep track of who's here. And also make sure if you finish and take pictures of it to tag the ASI team so that you're able to flex your Baby Yodas a little bit.
We love that.
There you go. Ready. Okay, what time is it? You want to start or do you want to keep waiting for a little bit longer, Herbert?
We're all ready.
Yeah.
Ready? Okay. So this is what we're going to draw, not this or this. That's my signature. But we're going to draw the child right here. I don't know if you can see my screen. I don't know how to clean it.
Share your screen with your phone so that it could be the main one.
You can pin it too, I think, right?
I think oh, yeah, we can pin your screen.
Yeah, let's pin this one so then I can. So what we're going to start with is going to be just a plain piece of paper. Can everyone see it? Are we all good? Yes.
Yep. Reaction. A little thumbs up.
Okay. So you're going to start with your pencil. Make sure it's a sharper edge. And we're going to lightly start. Make sure you also have your eraser handy because we will be using that a lot. Myself up. So to start with, we're going to create his little scarf, whatever you want to call it, to the top of his jacket here. So we're going to make a slightly curved line all the way across. This is going to determine how big your Baby Yoda is going to be. So if you want him to be bigger, go ahead and draw it bigger, but make sure you're able to fit him on your page because he does have big ears. So from the middle of your line that you just created or a little bit off, it's up to you because his middle scarf isn't perfect. It's fine. You're going to make a large S, a slanted S like that. I'm making mine a little darker so you can see it on the camera, but try your best to do it lightly so that way you can erase it. And we're going to, from the bottom of the S, continue it all the way to where you started, right there. Now with a line going vertically, we're going to connect those two at a slant, making another S. So since we started this one more or less in the middle, we're going to go more to the left here and create another line to offset and create the fold. And going back to our right, we're going to connect the two. If you have any questions, for sure, just leave them in the Zoom or group chat if I'm going too fast or anything, too. Okay, so from here, we're going to make a diagonal line, not all the way at the corner, going a little bit, not too much, to create his little sleeve. So just one line there. And we're going to do the same thing on the other side, trying to mirror it like so. Now with a curve, we're going to go straight following this same line that you did for his scarf. And we're gonna make a triangle. So you're gonna go up not too far and finish a triangle. And that's a little sleeve. Continuing, we're going to copy and we're going to mirror that on the other side, trying to make sure the edges here are curved. Horizontal. There we go. And we're going to make another triangle. Like so. Right, now this is the easier part. He's a little rectangle. However long you want him to be. Remember, do this a little lightly so that you can erase it when you're going to color it in later. I'm just doing it darker so that you can see it on the camera. And look, his little outfit, how cute. Okay. So right here under where this connects, you're going to create a line going all the way down to the bottom of his little outfit. And you're going to do that twice, but off. So there's going to be a little area in between. This is going to be darker. That way it looks like it's overlapping. Any questions so far? We good? So for his little head, we're going to go in on both sides. So where this ends, for his scarf, you're gonna go in just a smidge to create points of where you wanna keep his head inside. So you're gonna make a circle just without a bottom. And our goal is to be able to reach back here. Adjusting your paper might help you so that you're able to actually make it round. And we're gonna leave all of these extra lines if you have any and erase them after that way you still have an outline and you're able to adjust to whichever size you feel will fit him best. For his little ears, you're gonna start from the center and you're gonna follow the curve of his head, dip and go straight out. So following the curve of the circle, you're gonna make a horizontal line. Like so. And copy on the other side. The bottom of his ear, follow the circle again, and this time we're gonna dip. Create a dip, connecting the circle of his head, and we're gonna follow the dip and go straight to the top of the line that we created. We're gonna do the same thing. Ooh, I knocked off my cord. We're gonna do the same thing on the other side. Dip and connect it to the end. Okay. And you have his little outline.
Sage, that looks so cute.
You're Rufio, though.
Let's see what else. So for his ear, we're going to make another circle in the center of his ear on both sides. Make sure to do those lightly because we are going to erase them. So from the circle, we're going to make a triangle that connects on both the top and the bottom, pointing towards his little shoulder. Okay. Ball in the top, we're going to dip again and go straight out. Following the circle on the bottom, we're gonna dip the opposite way and go straight up. We're gonna copy that on the other side. Following this top of the circles is gonna help us create his ear and give him dimension when we're coloring them in later. I'm gonna follow the bottom of the circle again. And we created his little outline. Now this is where we're gonna use the erasers. We have, and we're going to erase the extra lines that we've created and the circle in the center of his head. So this on the side. I'm gonna clean up this because this almost touches, but still leaving the outline of his ear. Next thing we're gonna erase is the circles in the center of his ear. And this will allow you to create the shape that you want. Like so. Okay. We need more time? We're all good? Thumbs. Yes, tell me. Next, we're going to move on to his big eyes, which are just two circles. Kind of simple. Like that. Where did my other pencil go? Okay, so to get some of the dimension in his eye, we're going to start making a small circle, in the top left corners of his eye. And then a smaller one, white, right to the right of it. Like so. Next details we're gonna do are his little hands. So you're gonna make a C. And then you're gonna make another C, but this time facing the opposite way. So reversed. You're gonna round the bottom of the C and make a half circle connecting both. That way you have his little hands. We're going to do that on both sides. Like so. So now we're done with his outline. So for me, we're gonna start getting into coloring now. So if you have any color pencils, markers, paint, whatever you may be able to get your hands on, you could even technically do it with black and white. And so you could just use shading. So these are the colors I'm gonna use. I have three of each, more or less. That I'm gonna use for the shading here. Okay. And also I'm using a pen, which could be any pen that you have, just a black pen. And we're gonna take that pen to outline his little body right now. That way we can erase everything else we made. Okay, so just follow the pencil marks that you already have with your black pen. How are we doing? Looking good? Now we're gonna do his eyes. So we're gonna follow the circle that we made on the inner part of his eye and circle those and leave those white. So the inner part of the circles in his eyes are going to be white. And then we're going to follow the outer circle. And this one could be messy because we're going to fill it in black. So now we're going to follow the top part of his little jacket. Make sure to follow the S shape that you have. And just connect and outline it. For this seam in the center, we're going to go and follow the outer sides of the lines that we did so that we could still have the room in between so that we could shade it later. Same thing for these triangles. Outline them and then follow the rest of your lines that you already did. Remember, the lines that you already drew are just a sketch. So if you follow them perfectly, that's okay, because we're still going to color him in. And sometimes your eye sees things after. Don't forget his little hands. And now we're going to add a detail to his little hands. We're going to take our pens and behind in the center, make a point to add his third finger. And with your pen, try and round it out. And I'm gonna switch my pen so that that way I can make more details. And we're gonna draw his fingernails. So you're gonna go towards the tip and make a half circle. Now we're gonna erase again, getting rid of whatever extra marks you may have. Touches. And now it's time to color him in. How's it coming, Jen?
I could draw. This looks better, but like,
no, he looks so cute.
I feel like one of his ears is bigger than the other one. This one. Look at this one. Wait, how do I? Can you see it?
Yeah. No, he looks good. He has big ears. He looks so cute. Okay, so once we're done erasing, You're going to take your green. So I have my lightest shade of green here, and I'm just going to fill in his whole head. Very lightly if you only have one green. That way we can still shade. But we're going to start with one base shade of green. By lightly drawing on, we're able to put in his little wrinkles in his forehead and his eyebrows later with the same shade if we need to, and we can build. And for the lightest shading, I find using your pencil and not using the tip fully down, but more coloring on its side helps. I'm holding my pencil more like, oh, I guess a wand. There we go. Can't really tell. So I can adjust it. Using the same green and the light coloring, we're going to color in his fingers, but make sure you don't cover the tips where we're going to color that yellow for his nails. Now, the simplest thing is to do his nails, take a yellow color, and color in the tips kind of dark. Mine came out a little wonky there, but that's okay. Okay. Now, I'm going to go in with more of a minty blue, greenish color, and I'm going to fill it in to add a little more. Because I want some dimension at the top of his head. So if you're using the same green, go over the top to make it a little darker. Just at the top. So you're going to push towards the top line that we drew, the outline. And as you get closer to his eyes, you're going to lift and get lighter. So push and lift, push and lift, push and lift. And we're going to do the same thing at the bottom, right above his little scarf on his jacket, little cuff. Push and lift, just the opposite way. Push and lift. For his little ears, closer to the tip of his ear, you're going to push and you're going to pull and lift, following the curve of his ear to give him some dimension. So push and lift. So it should be darker going towards light as you get closer to his face. Like so. I'm going to keep continuing until I get the shade I want. I'm going in now with another darker color, but if you have the same one, just push and keep shading. Okay, now that we finished his shading, we can go in and do his little wrinkles. So pushing, if it's the same photo, or same photo, the same color pencil, we're gonna push harder so that it's gonna show up. We're gonna go from the center of his little head in between his eyes, but at the very top, and we're gonna push, and we're gonna make a straight line down. Like that. On his right side, we're gonna have one a little bit angled, and we're gonna point to the middle line, like so. And we're gonna repeat on the other side. That, pointing to his. For his eyebrows, we're going to come down following the same lines on the outside. And we're going to make an L and curve it. Rather than going straight, we're going to curve and follow the circle of his eye. And repeat, but this time it's going to be backwards. So follow that line, curve. Make sure you're pushing so it shows up. So. So now for his ears, I'm gonna take a red and outline the inner part. And I'm gonna fill the whole thing in with pink. I didn't push too hard. It's more of just filling it in, not pushing, but just filling it in so some sort of pink is on the paper. Following the red line, we're gonna push on top of the line to blend it. So right where the red is, push and lift towards the center. But we're gonna start on top of the red, push and lift. Push, push, push and lift.
Personally went a little too crazy with the red.
And if you keep circling with a light hand, you'll be able to blend those colors. Or some people might have like a full pack of colored crayons. That is actually what the white is meant for. It doesn't have any actual color when you just use on white paper, but when you put it over the colors, it'll blend it. So I'm gonna take my light and I'm gonna blend. Take your time with the blending, like that.
How's it coming, Lucy? Oh my gosh, he's so cute, Jen.
He's so cute.
He's so cute.
Everyone else? No one else needs to show it?
Herbert, that looks so good. That's what I'm talking about.
Wow.
Hold on, Linda, you're on mute.
Yeah, you're muted, Herbert.
I'm using dry erase markers because I don't have colored pencils.
I had my highlighter.
So good.
We love that.
An artist is someone that can use anything that's around them to produce something beautiful.
That part.
Well said, well said.
Hey, Bob Ross, we love that.
Okay. Once we're done blending, or when we finish, I'm gonna take 3 different browns, but you could use the same one, but okay, lightly, we're going to color in his whole top part of the jacket. Make sure you use the same pressure across the whole thing since it's supposed to be the same color. So, we're gonna take the same shading technique that we did where we pushed, and we're going to push hard in the center of this fold. To create some shadows, you're gonna use the tip of your pencil rather than the side, and you're gonna push and pull towards the center again, right under the middle S. Follow the shape that you created with the outline and the black marker, but as you get closer to the black line, you're gonna push harder to create it and make the shadow. This is gonna be the darkest point because that's where these two are gonna meet and would overlap to create the darkest shadow, and pull as you come to the center and lightly
shading. Like that. I'm going to create some shadow in this corner, darken the very far corner, and lift as you get towards the center. My hands are breaking. Follow the shape of the S so you can still have the shape throughout the color. And you can give it some dimension. Bye. Sorry, I was reading it. I'm slow. Bye. Okay. Now I'm going to switch colors. You can use the same one with a little more pressure than you did for the base color of his jacket, but less pressure than you did for his fold here. You're going to cover his whole entire jacket. Even these little triangles. Applying some pressure on the corner right here, I'm gonna create a shadow. And we're gonna, once again, from the black line, push and lightly pull up. Follow the bottom of the sleeve, push and pull up. Like so. Do the same on the opposite side, push towards the black and then lighten your grip as you go away from it. Following his little center crease, we're gonna shade again, push and pull up. The color I'm using makes his little jacket look kind of like a tortilla, but that's okay.
Kai, so is his robe supposed to be kind of like an olive green?
Yeah. Following the fold, you're going to push and pull so you can create some shadowing right there as well. So I'm gonna change back to the same color that I used for his little top of his jacket there, and I'm gonna color in the triangles. So using the tip so to go. Now I'm gonna go with a darker brown and I'm gonna color over the top of the triangles again. And follow my shading that I already did, just for a little bit more dimension. Just go lightly on top of it. And voila, you have the child.
I would never think I'd be good at shading, but like you did it so good, and I'm like copying you, and I'm like, holy crap.
Yay!
Magic.
And so for me, I see that the shading personally was a little rougher there. So I'm going to take my white and go over the top. My white doesn't bleed. And try and blend the colors some more. I never understood the point of white because you can't see it if you use it, but it's not a color. And I just found that out like a year ago.
You literally just taught me that.
So it's something new, bro. I was very happy when I figured it out. Pencil's broken. Pop up this little packet to blend some room. And there we go. The child. Make sure this is something my mom taught me. You always want to date what when you did it. Me trying to figure out the date. Oh my gosh. That's fine. I messed up. It's fine. This is where I need the white out.
You turn the dot into a 4.
Can I do that? That's the question. Okay, there we go. Herbert. Pull it through for me. Okay, and then sign it.
Good job, everyone.
That was fun for me. I hope you guys had fun too.
That was so fun. What the heck?
Honestly, that was super relaxing and like. Yes. Are we gonna show off our?
Yeah, I want to see everyone's.
Hey, y'all should take a picture of our little reveal.
My phone. I'm like, where's my phone?
It's on there. Okay.
Oh, that's awesome.
Oh my gosh. That looks so cute. Okay, mine was kind of put to shame. That was just too hard.
They went off.
That's awesome.
Oh my gosh, that's so cute.
Hold on. Keep them up. We're going to get a screen share real quick.
That is so cute.
All right.
This is honestly what goes on in my head 24/7. Baby Yoda. That's
it. All right, you definitely have to do more, please. Can we have your own channel on ASL?
Yeah.
I'm so down. I'm like, harass the ASI Instagram and say what you want to draw next. I'm
just kidding. Take a poll right now.
Leave a comment, like, I'm turning it to my YouTube page.
Hi. Hi. That was really nice.
Thank you, guys. I had fun. Thank you for having me.
Y'all.
What would y'all want to see next? Let's hear from our guests over here.
Ooh.
What would y'all want to see next if we do another draw and sip?
I want to see, is it, I don't know, Kim? How would I say your name? I'm sorry, I'm not good. I can't read.
I spelled it wrong. It's just Kim. It's just Kim. I accidentally put the E before I got in.
I don't want to say it wrong. Yours came out so cute. I loved it.
Thank you.
Put me to shame.
I'm trying to think of some other ones. What's your favorite to draw, Kai?
I don't know. It changes. It's more of my mood. Ooh. I really want to draw one of them. I want to draw a porg. I think those things are so cute. But honestly, if I'm going to tell you the truth, I have more of a tattoo sketch type of, that's what I like drawing, like old school tattoos.
Oh, so,
that's what I have a tendency to just fall back on. But yeah.
I'm definitely going to do this with my family later tonight, and we're gonna paint.
That's so cute. Yeah, the other one that I did, this one was painted.
Oh,
this one's gonna be, I think, I don't know how we're gonna share it, but I already recorded the how to on this.
Ooh.
And yeah, that'll be shared this coming week, next week. So then we can have multiple. You would be shocked at how many Baby Yodas I have just lying around the house now after practicing.
I love that, though.
That was the pre-recorded one, Kai?
Yes.
Okay.
So does it need any
editing, or you're good to just post it?
I'm sorry?
Does it need any editing, or you're good to just post it?
If you want to edit it, I'll be more than happy to give it to you.
Well, we have Pedro in the case that he does need to split. Like, or did you want just one long tutorial?
I can send it to you. It's on OneDrive, so.
Oh yeah, upload it and then we'll see what we can do with it.
Okay, sounds good. Thank you guys, I had so much fun.
Thank you. What's it called? Rise of Skywalker today on Disney Plus.
Oh, he's ready. Are you gonna keep your shirt on?
Yeah, I'm gonna keep it on. This is an all day thing.
I had a committee interview. And I was wearing Baby Yoda. Everyone was dressed so nice, and I was like,
I don't have any like big meetings today, so it's a good day.
I was darn. I totally went in with Baby Yoda shirt. Thanks for everyone that stayed and drew with me. I don't know.
Oh my god.
Oh my gosh.
Kim, that's awesome.
Did you make that? I forgot I had it, and I'm so mad.
Can we get a picture with all of our Yoda gear?
Yeah.
Almost done. All I have is my lightsaber.
Got the whole thing. My mom was trying to have me use a lightsaber earlier. I was like, please stop.
Is he like
a screen share real quick?
Wait.
All right, ready. 1, 2, 3. All right, we got it.
But where did you get that hat?
I know.
Please.
Oh, yes.
I absolutely adore that. It is the cutest thing I've ever seen. Ugh. For sure, let me know what you guys would want to see, because I have the other recordings that I need to do too, and I don't know what everyone else wants. Otherwise, we're going to be doing Disney for the rest of the school year.
No one can stop me. I'm for it.
I know. I'm not complaining.
I would also second that.
Do not encourage me. Got a lot of time on my hands. I kind of wanted to do, which I don't know. I wanted to do
all of the little, what are they called? Inside Out characters. Because I feel like that's very relatable right now. We're all going through those stages.
Yes. You know?
Or I was going to do some of the characters with little face masks on.
Ooh. Puns.
I love a good pun. So.
You know what? I wonder if we could do like a poll, Herbert, on Instagram to see like what, I don't know if we would have to pick two things and then they.
Do you have preferences, Kai? That way if we do a poll, like we provide them with options that you can draw.
Or Jen a whole list or whoever a list.
Send us a list. We'll do a poll, but I think we might do another live one.
Okay.
If you're down, Linda, because this was really good.
Yeah, I'm beyond down. I had so much fun. I'm not gonna lie, I was a little scared at first, but
yeah.
We got this. I got the setup too. I feel so professional.
I love the background. You were like, do the S, and I was like, okay, this is how I know how to draw. She's like, do an S, do two C's. I was like, okay, I got this.
we'll call it Kai's Drawing School, Drawing Academy. Yeah.
We did.
Kai's Drawing Academy.
You can use this as your resume.
What?
I'm like the ASI Academy, Drawing Academy. That's cute.
About
to make me some shirts.
Pre-market right now.
I know. Let them know.
That's a good idea.
I have to hop on another meeting, but it was nice hanging with y'all.
Alrighty. Toodaloo, y'all.
Thanks, guys.
Is it okay to end it? Because I'm not sure. Here.
Yeah, we're all good. Thanks, guys.
All right. Bye, y'all.
Bye.